Downloading an image into your iOS app used to be really hard, but not anymore. With SDWebImage, it's really, really easy and fast to do. Now, I want you to hit that subscribe button because in this video, we are going to do just that with an example project. So let me just show you what we are going to build out today. And I have here a demo project that I have just built out. As you can see, it has just one UI image view and two buttons. It's really, really simple to build that out. Go ahead and take a look at the GitHub repository down link in the description. Okay, and what we are going to do is fetch an image. And as you can see, we are fetching it and I'm displaying the result here in an alert. And if you just want to grab our image while not displaying it in a UI image view, then we are going to just display the image data from the result. Okay, so let's just close that and let's remove the view controller demo from as the root view controller. And let's just go to our view controller. And let me just guide you through what I have here. I'm using Spark UI. If you don't know what Spark UI is, go ahead and take a look at the description. And basically what I'm doing is using an SView controller and adding an image view fetch button and a grab button. Now, all of this comes, of course, with the Spark UI that I have built. It's really easy to set up. I'm stacking the image view fetch button and grab button like so. And then I'm just observing the taps on those two buttons. And I have here some extra function, which we will build out later on, which basically handles the image with error, cache type, and the URL. This is where we will show that alert that you saw earlier. So let's just start off by importing as the web image. And as you can see, it already is imported through Swift package manager. So if you just click on this plus button and the URL, so you need to add the URL here. So the URL can be found on GitHub. And if you go to the link for SD web image, and the link is in the description also in the resources, you just go ahead and click on this clone or download button and just copy it out by clicking again on this button. And just go back to Xcode and paste it in there and just follow along with the instructions and you will be just fine. Now I have also imported Spark UI because of this UI that I have just built out really, really fast. Okay, so that's that. Let's go back to our view controller. And as you can see here, we have SD web image already imported. Okay, and by the way, I have a URL that is from Unsplash. And yeah, go ahead and just use any type of URL that points to an image. Okay, so let's fetch an image. Now, fetching an image in my case is just displaying it also on a UI image view. So, and grabbing it is just grabbing, downloading, and later on, we will just do whatever we want with it. Okay, so first of all, let's fetch it and display it in that image view. Okay, fetch button. So first of all, we need to create a download URL because yeah, that's a string that we have, but it might not be a real URL. So let's go ahead, let unwrap that. Else we are just simply going to return. Let's do nothing. Okay, let me just move this a little bit up so you can see better. Finally, let's just see what happens here. So yeah, we need to have self here because we are in a completion. Yeah, this is reactive programming from ReactiveKit. We are inside a tab observer. Yeah, so that's a closure. That's why we need to reference the URL string with a self. So now that we have a download URL, we will also use a placeholder if there is any placeholder needed. Now, I have already added the placeholder here, or did I? Let me just add that placeholder right now. Let's go to Documents, Work, and here we have our logo. So let's just drag and drop that logo right over there in the assets. How awesome is that? Okay, so let's go to our view controller, and now let's create our placeholder. So the placeholder is basically a UI image. So let's see, there we go. And it will be named logo. I already know that that image is named logo. Okay, So now we have to use SDImage view, and it's really, really simple. Now that we have a download URL and a placeholder, we just call that on the image view. So self, because we are in the completion, image view, and let's just start typing SD underscore. And as you can see, there are quite a lot, but I will use the one with the placeholder. So, and the one that is with the completed. So set image with URL, placeholder options, and completed. Okay, so for the URL, we are going to use the download URL. And here, as you can see, it's an optional, but yeah, we have already guardlet unwrapped that. Okay, placeholder, an optional UI image, and that's good because named images are also optional. So placeholder, there we go. As you can see, it's an optional. And options, that will be an empty array. I don't really care for now. And the completion block returns you an optional UI image error and URL, and of course an SD image cache type that we will talk in just a moment. So let's just type out here all of these. So image error cache type and URL. Now this is a real URL, it's not a string, just so you know. And finally, we want to use this handle image error cache type URL pre-built function that I already have here, so we don't clutter that completion. So self handle image error, there we go, image error . How nice is that? And basically that's it. Now we want to handle that information. And what we are going to do is, I just copied it out because it's really, really simple from my cheat sheet here on the left. And I just paste it in. It's really, really simple to do. We are just going to check if there is an error. If there's an error, I'm going to use S alert controller, show error. This is a simple UI alert controller from Spark UI. You could use a simple UI alert controller for your case. After that, I'm guardlet unwrapping an image and the URL. I'm creating a message. As you can see, this is a multi-line message string. And then I'm just going to show it in a success alert controller. Again, this is from Spark UI, S alert controller. So yeah, that's just showing a simple alert controller with these information. So let's just build and run again and see what happens now. So yeah, we should get that image downloaded from that URL that we specified. Okay, let's tap on fetch image. And as you can see, it loaded it, success. There's the image size, the cache type. Now, the cache type is set to 1, and there's the URL, just so you know. Now, let's talk a little bit about the cache type, because I just close this. And if we go to SD image cache type, let's jump to definition. As you can see, there's a none, type disk, type memory, type all. Now, none is 0, type disk is 1, memory is 2, and type all is 3. Now, if you want to know this, then you should create an enum for that. But yeah, that's just it. So now you know what that one means, because we already downloaded a few minutes ago. Okay, finally, let's talk about grabbing the image, not just displaying it in an UI image. Well, most probably you will do this most of the time, but sometimes you just want to download the image and just use it later on. So for that, we are going to grab an image. And to grab an image, first of all, we need a manager. So let's just create that. So let image manager equals, and of course we are going to use SD web image and manager. There we go. So now that we have our manager, we can load an image on that manager. So image manager, load image, and let's just use this one with the URL, options, and the progress, because I want to show you all about the progress. Of course, on the set image, you could also have the progress set if you choose another one, but I will show you the progress right over here. So URL, I will just copy out this URL from here. There we go. And let's just add it right over there. URL equals is the download URL, options, an empty array, and the progress. Now this is a progress block, so let's hit return here. And as you can see, we are returning two ints and an optional URL. Now the first int is the received size, and the second one is the total size. So received size, total size, and URL. Okay, now what we need to do is just print out the received size and the total size. Of course, you can calculate the percentage of how much percentage has been downloaded. So again, I would just copy out this real quickly so we don't waste time with that. And you can see that I have just, sorry, not there, under the code, I've just created the percentage and I'm just printing it out. Okay, next up is the completion block. Okay, and it is the same. Now we also have a success boolean value, like did it finish, like did it finish downloading. Okay, let's add in here image data error cache type finished and URL. Okay, and of course we can check if the completion has finished. So if finished, else we are going to, let's just print out loading image did not finish. So as alert controller, let's use show error or show warning rather. Just a simple warning, show warning and loading image did not finish. Okay, otherwise, let's just use the handle that I have just created. So self handle with the image error cache type and URL. Of course, you could use the data also if you wanted to, but this is really, really simple. Okay, let's just build and run and see what we got. And as you can see, it's really, really to use as the web image. So let's grab our image success cache one, and here is our URL. How awesome is that? And finally, let's just fetch an image cache two, URL, and the image size. Really, really handy, and that's how simple it is to use as the web image. So now you know how easy it is to download images into your iOS app with the help of SDWebImage. Now I want you to hit that notification bell because in my next video I will be talking about the coordinator pattern. That's right, we are going to talk all about navigation. Now while you wait for that, make sure to check out these videos as well too. I talk a lot about Swift, in general UIKit, and as usual, I will see you in the next one.